For that, we have Mr. Warren Pettit from Louisiana, lawyer, and a long-time practicing lawyer, also a skills professor at Loyola Law School in New Orleans, and also very well known for his involvement in the Acadian community in Louisiana, and representing that community in various events around the world. And so we have a proud Acadian American lawyer to speak to us about civil litigation options, and I welcome Professor and lawyer Mr. Perrin.
Bonjour à tout le monde. The word Acadian has been mentioned several times. I suspect some of you don't know why we call ourselves Acadians. I hope that in the next 20 minutes, I will convey to you a fascinating, exhilarating, frustrating story of our Acadian ancestors. I'm going to do that because I've been requested to explore how I have used the courts and not used the courts to obtain damages for victims of countries or companies. I'm reminded that the topic was brought up in the movie Jerry Maguire, and Tom Cruise famously said, "Show me the money." Well, I'm going to show you the money because I've been doing that for 45 years. And I was asked to prepare my paper, which, by the way, I have copies at the end of that table, freeing me from getting into too much tall weeds about the details. If you want the statutes, the quotes, the actual lawsuits that were filed, they're in that paper. But I do this on a contingency. My law firm doesn't get paid by the hour. We're like hunters and gatherers. We have to kill to eat. If we don't win, we don't get paid. So I'm going to discuss briefly the four cases that I think could be germane, and then I'm going to spend hopefully the last 10 minutes showing you Acadian history and how I got led an effort of 15 years to get the Queen of England and the apology or acknowledgement of wrongs that had been perpetuated in the name of the British Crown and the deportation of my ancestors. And I want you to think about the word deportation. It's not exile. What we see in Syria and other places, we see people going into exile. That is a voluntary action forced by uncontrollable forces. Deportation is a forced act thrust upon people instantaneously. Quite a difference. And you will see the history of my Acadian ancestors who were deported and victims of an ethnic cleansing in North America, the first of its kind against European settlers. So, I represent victims. I am what's called a Cajun. The word Cajun is what we call Acadians only in Louisiana, because when my ancestors arrived 250 years ago, they introduced themselves as "Nous sommes des Acadiens," and the Acadien was translated over time to Cajun, 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 Cajun. So we are in the world in at least 40 different places, Acadian people, and they are all called Acadians. There are Acadians in France, in Texas, in Massachusetts, and in Maryland. And I invited two of my dear friends from Maryland to join me. I'll ask them to stand because Mr. Greg Woods and Lynn are historians and they're experts in the Acadians of Maryland. Vietnam. We have an incredible similar history. Catholic, French, The same percentage of Cajuns still speak French as do Vietnamese. I had a fabulous opportunity in November of 1997 to be one of the first Americans to return to Hanoi shortly after the normalization of relations between Vietnamese people and the United States people. I was a guest of Jacques Chirac, President of France, and accompanied the French delegation for the World Francophone Summit. When I took a tour of the countryside, I could have closed my eyes and thought I was back in my hometown of Henry, Louisiana. I was raised on a rice farm. I pulled weeds from my dad's rice farm. So to be back in Vietnam, speaking some French, eating some good hot food, which we had last night, plenty of, I felt like home. So we have this interesting parallel between our people of Louisiana and the people of Vietnam. So, the first lawsuit I will mention is I have pending today a lawsuit against Iran, because in 1983, terrorists financed and under the direction of the Iranian government blew up the Marine barracks, killing 253 U.S. Marines, including my client, a 19-year-old Acadian boy named Lex Patrol. I represent him, his estate, and his family, along with several other of the Marines killed, and we have pending a $40 million lawsuit against Iran. Once we obtain judgment, we will execute the judgment and collect the damages that the court here in Washington, D.C. will award to us from a fund which has been created, presently has about $2 billion, for reparations of victims killed or injured by the countries listed as sponsors of terrorists, and Iran is one of them. The next case, and I will mention that the jurisdiction was created for our suit and any suit against a state sponsored terrorism. There was an act passed by Congress called the Foreign Sovereign Immunities Act, creating a separate jurisdiction and a court here in Washington to hear our case. So stay tuned. That's ongoing as I speak to you today. The next suit I will mention is the suit I filed in 1998 against ExxonMobil that had built the largest gas processing plant in North America on my family's property, the Broussards. The Broussards are one of the largest Acadian families in the world, and most of them settled in Louisiana. After 15 years of litigation, we were successful in reaching a compromise on the eve of a trial where ExxonMobil pled guilty to hazardous material polluting the environment and set up a fund of $40 million to restore and clean my family's property. They are cleaning it up as I speak to you today. The third suit I will mention is another suit I have pending, which we filed 2 years ago on behalf of the Thibodeau family, another very large Acadian community family in Louisiana throughout the world. In Louisiana, we still have the Napoleonic Code, the Code Civil. We inherited it when we were still part as a colony, and we maintained it. And we are the only state that has it. Every other United States state has the British Common Law. Quebec is the only province in Canada that also maintains the civil code. Under that code, Napoleon wanted to make damn sure no one could keep his boats from going anywhere. So he passed Article 450, which we inherited in Louisiana, meaning that when you lose your land, the coastal erosion, and it becomes submerged, it can be enough to float a toothpick. But if it becomes submerged, it belongs to Napoleon. It belongs to the state. And we have inherited that law. And my family and many other families along the coast of Louisiana are losing land due to coastal erosion. It's due to the activities of the oil and gas industry since 1950, and it's due because the state of Louisiana, to shell roads, destroyed the reefs that had protected the coastlines for centuries. And it's estimated that in the last 60 years, Louisiana has lost over 2,000 acres of wetlands. So this suit we have pending seeks to address that issue and right that wrong. Stay tuned, very important. The final one, and we're going to now go to a PowerPoint, which I normally present this PowerPoint over an hour and a half lecture. So we're going to do this in about 8 minutes, so bear with me. We're going to go quickly, and we're going to discuss the suit I launched against the Queen of England in 1990. And in 2003, we were able to reach a successful resolution where we sought no money. We sought a redemption, and we sought to clear the name of our Acadian ancestors who were illegally deported by the British government in violation of British laws. And we gave the Queen an opportunity to right historical wrong, and she did it. And we never actually filed the suit. We did it through the legal system of preparing a suit, which is in the paper, and delivering it to the Queen and to Margaret Thatcher, giving them 30 days to respond or we would have filed the suit. Don't tell anybody what I'm about to tell you. There was no jurisdiction for this suit. None whatsoever. I was flying by the seat of my pants. On the 28th day, the British Information Agency called me and said, please don't file your suit. Our lawyers will be contacting you. Which led to 15 years of intense negotiations. Public opinion supported us and allowed us to obtain a result. The historic honor and dignity of our ancestors. Okay. So